Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 35 says, "Therefore, do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward." That word, great reward, could refer to a salary or payment that is due, but it also refers to a recompense or a reimbursement or a settlement, right? So here the writer of Hebrews is saying, don't cast away your confidence in the Lord. Don't throw it away, don't put it away, because there is a reward at the end of it, which means that God is our great rewarder, right? God will not do less than what a human employer would do. You know, we are serving Him as believers. We are doing what He has called us to do, and we are on a mission which has been commissioned by Him. So God will take care of our needs, right? He is not like a human employer. He's not less than a human employer. A human employer has a responsibility. He's accountable to the employee in order to make a payment or give a reward in return for the work, in return for the service. So how can we think of God any less than a human employer? Right? We expect a human employer to reward employees properly, and how much more our God, who is just and fair, right? And He will take good care of those who do His will. Now, God is mindful of the time that we invest, of the love and patience and the resources that we use for serving Him in His kingdom. He's mindful. He's a debtor to no man. He will ensure that we are recompensed, that we are rewarded, that we are paid back. So this word suggests that God will be sure to remember everything. Nothing escapes His attention. Nothing escapes Him. There's no information. There's nothing that we can put behind Him. So He sees everything. He knows everything. He knows every little detail, the times that we have invested, the work that has gone in. So therefore, He is the rewarder. So we do not, the writer of Hebrews says, don't cast away your confidence. You know, your confidence in the Lord, your confidence in the work of God. Do not cast it away. Hebrews 11 and verse 6 also has this to say, but without faith it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So we see that word again, that He is a rewarder. So God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him to do His will. You know, He will not shun away He will not shy away from rewarding us. He is a rewarder. When we diligently seek Him, when we diligently do His will, He will reward us. So, as believers, let us raise our level of expectation. Let us raise our faith level. And let us not be dismayed or disappointed. Let us understand that we will never be put to shame. Those who trust in the Lord will never be put to shame. Let's pray. Father, we thank You that You are the great rewarder. We thank You that You Yourself are our great reward. And Master, we thank You as Your word has exhorted again that, Lord, You are a rewarder of those who diligently seek You. Father, we thank You. And God, we thank You that none of what we do, O God, escapes Your attention. Everything that we do, every investment and what we do with our resources, everything that we've done in the service, O God, of the King of Kings, Lord, is not without reward. And so, Father, we thank You that You are the great rewarder. We thank You that You take care of our needs, Lord. And we give You all the praise and we give You all the glory. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.